Good grief, what a busy month May was. It's gone, and I need to bring you May's monthly favorites. All right, so I have quite a bit. I mean, I am talking that I have a lot of products that I tried this month, but I also went into my stash and pulled out some other things I want to talk about today. We're going to go over everything that I loved. I do have one fail in here. I think it's one fail. But everything else are things that I really, really like and I can't wait to show you. So I want to start out really quickly with a hair product. You all have been so sweet and so generous in your comments about my hair, and I really appreciate that. I talked a little bit about it in a video this month, but this is something that I got as a sample. I buy the Kenra hairspray, the 25. I've used it probably for 20 plus years. I love that hairspray. It's not sticky, it's not crunchy, and it holds my hair really well. But this one came as a little sample next to it, and this is the Kenra Nitro Memory Firm Hold Cream Mousse. This is awesome, you guys. I would never have picked this up myself because I haven't had a lot of success with cream products, and I definitely, you know, have a hit and miss love affair with mousses, but I like body and I like my hair to feel full. This is it. Do I feel like it's a 3-day hold like it says right here on our 3-day style memory? I don't really feel like it does that, but I do feel like it has a great hold to it. And the other thing that I love about it is that my hair feels full and thick when I use it. My hair is stick straight, it's very fine, and it is thinning all the time. I have back and forth bouts with falling out, and that's why I had to cut so much off of my hair. But this stuff makes my hair feel thicker when I do use it, and right after I blow dry and style my, I just feel like I have so much more hair, and I love that about it. Now, it comes in the typical mousse delivery system. What I will tell you is a tiny bit of this goes a long way, especially if you do have fine hair. If you use too much, you're gonna feel like your hair is weighted down and you're not gonna like it. So it squirts out just like a regular mousse, but it comes out a little bit too much, I find. So I try and get just a tiny bit out to use it. But I feel like this little one's gonna last me a long time because so little goes such a long way. But I will definitely be repurchasing this one. And yeah, I really have been liking that one. And it's been standing up during the humidity as well, which is why I love their hairspray so much. Also, before we get into what I found or what I've been trying in the month, I want to talk to you about the Becca Light Shifter or Light Shifting Powder. I don't remember what it's called. I've talked about this so much on my channel that you guys are probably sick of it. But what I want to tell you is right now it's on sale for half price. This is my ultimate love. I have backups. This is actually all three colors. I will just show you really quickly. This is color number one, and then this is color number two, and then color number three. You can tell that I've worn down one and two, and I just got three and have been using it, and it works so nicely as I'm tanning. They're very, very light, airy, very thin powder. It will never make you look cakey. I can put a lot of this powder on. I can dig my brush in there, put it on. It never makes me look cakey. It just helps perfect my skin and blur out my pores. I'm in love with this. I have so many backups, especially since they went on sale. I ordered a bunch. I am upset that they are going out of business and I won't be able to find this, but hopefully I'll have enough for a really long time and somebody will come out with it. This is the lightest one right here. They really don't look like anything when you get them on this on your skin. I mean, you want to kind of match your skin tone, but you don't want to worry too much about that. Really, truly, as they blend away, you don't have to worry about it. If you were very, very fair or very, very dark, I would worry a little bit more about it. But this is, again, number three. That's my newest one. And it doesn't, even that one, when you put it on, it doesn't really look like anything. It just blends into the skin, melts into the skin, and it's gorgeous. I use this all the time to set my under eyes. It's the only thing I use under there now. Doesn't look cakey at all. This is probably the most beautiful powder I've ever encountered. And I like, there's a lot of powders that I do like, but this is beautiful. I do, however, have kind of a dupe. It's really, really close. I'll make sure that I talk about it in my next dupes video. dupes video, which is going to be coming up within the next week or so. A lot of you ask me every single time I use this brush. This is a fan kabuki brush that I got, I can't even tell you how long ago, because everything is worn off of it. I think it was from Morphe back way back in the day. I probably have had this for 7 years. It's just held up so well. But I do have one that is almost identical that you can get on Amazon for around $6 or $7, and I'll make sure that I link that. But this brush is so good for blending in all of my contour if I want it to, but I use it more for bronzer than anything, especially while I'm in these summer months and it's so warm and I'm just using bronzer. This is great. It's a little bit fluffier. It's very thick. It's very soft, but it buffs in products really well. And it buffs in cream products really well, which is why I like it as well. Now, the cream product that I've been using for bronzer that I did want to show you this time is from Danessa Myricks. This is actually her contour. You guys know how I feel about orange in a contour product, and this does kind of lean a little bit more towards the warm side. So I use this more as a bronzer. It is a cream, which I love. I love the size of the pan. Danessa Myricks has come to Sephora, and I got this long before that because I heard about it first on Dana Anna's channel. I love her channel. I love that girl. She is just so much fun and so down to earth. But she was talking about how great the foundation was, and then I saw this cream product and I was like, whoa, I gotta try that. So you can tell that it is a little bit more warm, but why I like it is it's a little bit more on the cool side for being a warm bronzer. And I just tap in this kabuki brush or this fan brush, and then I'll just warm up places. And what you can see immediately is that it looks like there's too much on there, but then you can really buff it in and it just blends so well. And this brush does a great job with it too, but I love the product itself. It just blends so good. And the reason I love cream products for my mature skin is there's not gonna show up any texture. It's gonna look more hydrated. They're not gonna make you look dried out. Really, really enjoy this. I also did that video collab on sunscreens for the summer and with my good friend Melanie from Mr. Kong's mom. By the way, any of you that follow her, she did lose Mr. Kong this week. Her pug was quite old and there was a lot of disabilities with him, and I'm gonna get choked up because she loved that dog so much. And yeah, she lost him. So if any of you follow her on Instagram, go show her some love. We all that love animals know how hard it can be to lose an animal. So this is Can Make. This is the sunscreen. It's called Mermaid Skin, and it is SPF of 50 plus. And this works so well underneath my foundation. And this would be my number one pick for a sunscreen anytime, winter or summer. This is a mineral sunscreen, but I do know that it does have a little bit of chemical sunscreen in it as well. But it protects my skin so nicely. It goes underneath makeup so nicely. That's what I'm always looking for with sunscreen, is that it doesn't have a super white cast. This does come out as white, but once you rub it in, it goes right away. So it does have that mineral sunscreen quality to it, but it doesn't act like that where you get the white cast or the flashback or anything. So this is one of my very favorites, and I wanted to make sure I put it in here. And then also, because it's been so very hot where I am, it's super hot, I wanted to recommend this Bella Jade setting spray for your makeup. This is a great setting spray because it contains absolutely no alcohol and it uses green tea. Green tea is really good because it shrinks the capillaries, so it takes away puffiness. And then what it also does is it also helps with that longevity, because it kind of mattifies the makeup just a little bit, because green tea has that caffeine in it, and caffeine is a diuretic, which takes out the extra moisture that you might have on your face because of sweating or the heat or anything like that. So this is a great spray. I will say that it has a terrible squirt nozzle. It's just, the spray nozzle is terrible. I don't use it. I put it either on a makeup sponge, or my preferred way is to put it on a brush and then apply it. But as far as the product inside, it's fabulous. You could put it into another container if you wanted to. During the summer, what I use for my self-tanning, I get asked this a lot, is tan towels. This is a product that I have used for like 12 or more years, way, way, way before I ever had a YouTube channel. Tantals basically are a towelette, kind of like when you eat at Kentucky Fried Chicken and you get that little towelette to clean your fingers off. That's what these are. And they do have a little bit of alcohol in them. But what I love about them is two things. I never get streaky. I can use this as my, across my face, across my decollete, legs, wherever, and they never get streaky. I use the classic color, or that's the medium color. They have the regular or the original, and then they have these, which are the classic, and then they have the dark. I use the medium because I don't want to go too dark. It just looks silly on me if my skin gets too dark, but these are beautiful. They don't cause an orangey tan. They don't transfer onto your clothes. Now, I will say that you do want to wait for this to dry down. And the half towel, which is this right here, and then this is the whole towel. The whole towel will do my arms, my legs, my upper body right here above my chest, and then it'll do my legs completely. The half towel I just use when I want to do my face, my arms, and my chest, and my shoulders. They come in kits like this. You can get them on auto delivery or just try them once. They work so good for me. The tan lasts approximately 4 to 7 days, depending on, you know, what I'm doing. If I'm sweating a lot, if I'm showering a lot, I shower a little bit more in the summertime. But they last and last. I will tell you to exfoliate before you use these. You want to do that, and you want to make sure your skin is completely dry, and you're going to have to wait approximately about 20 minutes after you apply them to get dressed. Like I said, they don't transfer themselves onto your clothing. So if you accidentally get it onto some clothing, it's not going to stain your clothing. But your own tan, when you have it on after you've used these and you have a couple of days, it will transfer onto your clothing. I've never noticed it staining my clothing though, just so you know. These are wonderful. I love that I don't have to use the lotion or the gel, and it doesn't look streaky. It doesn't look patchy. It just works so good for me. And I can use it on my face too. But it does have that alcohol, so my face does dry out. I just go ahead and I put my cream on like 20 minutes after I've applied these, and they dry down like a dream. So I really have loved those for years, and I've tried so many others. Always go back to Tantals. I wanted to tell you about a palette that I've been trying. I actually been trying a lot of things from BH Cosmetics because I hadn't had a lot, and I want to put that in one of my drugstore reviews. So this is Smitten in Switzerland. I think this is so much fun for a palette. It's what I have on my eyes today. The look is very cool toned. I use this one down here, which is a very cool toned brown. This one up here, which is a silver. This one over here, which is a cool tone kind of taupe color. You use the cream on my inner corner and a tiny, tiny bit of this blue just out there by the outer corner. It is so pretty. I love these shadows. They're very creamy, very buttery, very beautiful. They look great on my mature lids. I don't have any room here to do any swatches. And I am very impressed with the formula. I'm impressed with the metallic formula. It's very soft. I'm impressed with how well these mattes blend out. I think they're great. They just work so well. That one was that berry one that I put on. Just really think that these are beautiful palettes. I didn't realize how great they were. I'm really in love with them. I wish that they would bring them back because I've heard that there are so many others that are the themes of different cities or different countries. And yeah, I'm kind of sad that I missed out on all of those. I also want to tell you about this Exa foundation. That's the one that I'm trying on this side of my face today. I have a NYX on the other side. This is a great color for me. It's very cool toned. I'll make sure that I throw the color up there. But this is a very hydrating foundation. At the same time, it is a very perfecting foundation. It's light. It's not too heavy on my mature skin. It's natural finish. It's not matte. It's not luminous. It's a very natural finish. I've loved it so far. I've used it probably for a month and a half now, maybe 6 weeks. But I didn't want to tell you guys about it until I tested it when it got super hot. So I am using it now that it's getting warm, and I'm still liking it very, very much. I will say that since it is a natural finish, you do have to put a tiny bit of powder on it, maybe the Becca powder or another powder that you love. I have been using the Flower Beauty powder just a little bit to set down around my nose and through my chin sometimes. That one works really good too. But this is a great foundation. It covers all of my imperfections. It is about a medium coverage to begin with, but you can build on it. If you need more higher coverage, you could thin it out with a moisturizer or a primer if you wanted just a tint instead of, you know, more of a foundation. And I really like it. It's one that I've really been enjoying a lot. And yeah, I couldn't wait to bring it to you. I probably should do a wear test for you guys on it so that you can see. But today I do have it on this side and you can see that it's a very perfecting and it gives just a very natural look to my skin. It doesn't look matte, but it doesn't look too glowy at the same time other than these beaming cheeks that I have. And speaking of which, I talked about a blush product that I brought out of my collection. That's this Juvia's Place Sahara 2 Blush Palette. First of all, I love their powders. They're fantastic. Their shadows are amazing, but this blush palette is so much fun. If I'm on in a rush one day and I don't want to worry about anything, I can go across and just buff it across my cheeks. I got a custom color that is so pretty. But I want to swatch all of these for you so you can see the colors. So there's the colors and oh my goodness, aren't they pretty? They are so wearable. I am not somebody that really likes that orangey color, but you mix that color with like this plum one down here, this rose one down here, and it's just beautiful. Even that bronzer color that is right here that is very orange, if you are using that in the summertime when you already have a little bit of a tan and you're just mixing it with some of these cooler colors, it's so beautiful. I just have been really impressed with it. And I've been loving that I can put it on top of cream products and they seem to play so well together. I do have this pink on right here with a cream blush underneath it right there. And I just highlighted my cheeks a tiny bit with this right here underneath my blush. Now, I really think that this is a palette that looks good on anybody's skin. You have the warm to the cool and the in-between, and if you want to make one of them cooler, you can mix colors together. It's just a great palette and it's not very expensive. So this is one that I've loved for a long time, kind of forgot about it, pulled it out of my stash and was really excited to be using it again. Oh, by the way, they do have a deeper one, the Saharan 1 blush palette, that is for medium to deeper skin. Absolutely gorgeous if you have deeper skin. And I told you I have a fail. I do. That is this one from Morphe. This is the 18H Sweet on Hue Morphe palette. I was so excited to get this because it has all of these pastels in it, and I have a hard time finding pastels. The colors are pretty, they're vibrant, they go on really well. My complaint about this palette is that it doesn't last very long on my eyes. I don't have this on at the end of the day when I go and look at my makeup. It's just gone. And even with using a really, really good primer, I couldn't get them to stick. That was my one regret this month that I purchased. I hope that you did enjoy seeing all of these products for the month. Please tell me in the comment section what you found this month that you fell in love with, or if you pulled out something from your stash that you love too. I'd love to hear that from you. Hope you guys are all doing well. I'm going to be moving very soon, so I wanted to tell you about that. It might be a little hit and miss on my videos. Hopefully not. I'm going to batch film a bunch for you guys so I can make sure that you guys don't miss out on any content. Love you guys so much. Please take care of yourselves, and I'll catch you all in my next video. Bye, friends.